Cause you need just one. I see you looking, but you hard to impress, huh? Then you find me. Now you clear the five drive time. Best, it's the Beyond the Burrell Show. You gon' listen up for what you been missing, man. She hot. Who you got for your radio? Drop the new entrepreneur, make my radio rock. From Atlanta to the Cayman, internet came and out of East and the West. Both loving what you're saying. And this is not game of day. She hit me up like I'm a friend. Who's never gonna love what you play? You are tuned into your girl Bianca Burrell on the Beat Drops Radio, your top 45 and R&B station. New beat of Atlanta. The caller number is 404-826-9223. Man, I haven't talked to y'all in a while, but that is all right. If you want to see everything that's happening live as it happens, go to thebeatdropsradio.com. Click on Watch Live. The Q&A box is open. It takes about 30 seconds lag time in order for us to see it. As long as you're not acting crazy, we will address you. The listen line, in case you're about to walk away from your device, somebody wants to listen, they don't have internet, all of that, Obama phone, I don't know what it is. Anyway, the listen line is 401-347-0418. Again, 401-347-0418. There's a lot of things that's happening in the news right now. It is the holidays, and we appreciate everybody for tuning in. Hey, what's going on? All right, so there's been another shooting that's taking place, like maybe about 2 miles away from Ferguson, but the mayor says, don't compare, just hold on. So we got some sound bites for that. And we're going to have some dialogue in regards to that. And the interview, the movie that, you know, apparently has caused so many problems with, what's his name, Kim Jong-un?
Kim Jong-un, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. Well, looks like it's going to be released in T-Way. So we'll talk about exactly how that's going to happen. I got a special in-studio guest with me. It's my brother, y'all. Rodney is in the building. What's going on, man?
Hey, nothing much. How you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm with me, finally.
I'm glad to be here.
I don't know. Just 2 years.
Normally I'm on the phone. This time I got to fly in, yeah. Having a good time.
That's good. I'm glad to hear that. We're gonna play a few songs, kind of, you know, moisten the ground just a little bit. Just kind of, well, actually the ground is moist. Man, it's raining like a mold soul here.
Oh my God.
Okay, so now I've got the intern slash son over there wrapping me up. That's crazy. He gonna tell me to wrap it up. I'm just saying. So keep it up right here on the Bianca Burrell Show. If you haven't done already, like us on our Facebook page by going to thebeatdropsradio.com. Click on the Facebook icon and take it directly there. Once you like us, suggest it to your friends. Follow us on Twitter at Beat Drops Radio. And my Instagram is Bianca_Burrell. We're going to kick it off with DJ Cassidy and R. Kelly. Make the world go round. Keep it up.
Your skin is so clear. What's the secret? It's I know papaya and egg whites. No. Peruvian asphalt and ionized water. Not it's got to be the duck base and Moroccan cocoa oil. I know that works.
Not that.
So what is
it? It's power shake.
Oh, what?
Aftershave lotion.
Oh, can you hear okay? I need to turn you up something.
The Web Zone, Stone Mountain's premier state-of-the-art technology center, invites you to listen to today's hit music, enjoy refreshments, network, and plug into the World Wide Web in our relaxing atmosphere. Located in Northeast Atlanta, The Web Zone Cyber Cafe offers a convenient and enjoyable location to check your email, surf the internet, print, scan, fax documents, and make copies, all in one location. Visitors can connect to the internet using our high-speed computers and receive online assistance at no additional charge. Our 1,500 square feet Cyber Cafe is staffed with highly qualified and knowledgeable trainers. We deliver up to 8 internet-ready computers to your community center and train seniors to effectively use the computer and safely surf the internet. Visit us online at www.thewebzoneatl.com or call 770-465-4000 for more information and rates. The Web Zone. Get away.
You are tuned in to the Bianca Burwell Show on the Beach House Radio, your top 45 and R&B station. New bit of Atlanta, calling number is 404-826-9223. Again, 404-826-9223. If you want to see everything that's happening as it happens, go to thebeachhouseradio.com. Click on Watch Live. The Q&A box is open. In order to use the Q&A box, right on the bottom, it says Join the Conversation. Join the conversation. When you click on that, then you can type whatever you want to. But we appreciate everybody. And I see St. Petersburg, Florida. Am I saying it right? St. Petersburg?
Yes.
Okay, saying it right. Atlanta, of course. Atlanta, St. Louis, Missouri. And Parts Unknown. Not the show. Seriously, it's Parts Unknown. It just says Parts Unknown. But we appreciate you for tuning in. The part of the Philippines, it says Makati, M-A-K-A-T-I.
Don't give me the line to you. I know where it's at. I don't know how to pronounce it.
Okay. Appreciate you for tuning in as well. So I have my second oldest brother in the building with me today. Typically, he's that voice that you sometimes hear on the airwaves, sometimes when we have New Order, National Human Rights Organization. And shout out to Gerald Rose.
Gerald Rose.
What's going on, man? He clicked like, he let me know he is on vacation.
No plans on coming in.
He was like, no, dude. I'm on vacation. I'm out until January. So enjoy your vacation, man. But I still appreciate you for chiming in and listening. So what's been going on? I mean, you showed up.
Yes.
You
big surprise. Yeah. Big surprise for everybody. Love the look on mom's face. She didn't appreciate me posting that picture on Facebook.
No, I think she was glad it was funny.
Yeah.
It was a little out of focus.
Well, she was kind of shaking me at the time.
Yeah. You almost made her fall out, though.
It's been a while since I've been to the ATL.
Yeah. You were here for the launch of the
launch party of the station, right?
Yeah, that took place April. Yep, 2012, April. We launched the Beach House Radio. And that was a momentous occasion for me.
Yeah.
My buddy Tony Terry jumped in. He was on tour. I didn't even expect him to like roll through.
Yeah, he's a cool cat.
Yeah.
Cool cat.
Yeah, I appreciate him coming. And just looking back, you know, a lot has taken place over the last couple of years, especially with the station.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm grateful. But sometimes, as a business owner, you have to hit the reset button. But this is your first time in the station, though.
It's the first time operational. My first time in this one. I went to the first location.
Yeah.
But I had to leave before you actually went on the air. Then Bobby came in. He was there for a while.
Yeah.
So, this is my first time. And it's fitting that it would be the last one before you hit the reset button.
See, there you go. First and the last. Man. You see, I got a couple pictures up. I didn't get a chance to put up all the pictures I wanted to. Yeah, me and Mila from formerly of 702, but new cast member at the top there.
Yeah, I see that. And I knew MC Light would be up there.
Oh, of course. You see, I'm cheesing hard. I think that's the hardest cheesing. And she said, was that cool? I'm like, man, my hair could have been standing on top of my head. As long as I'm next to you. I'm putting that up, and then myself and Bernice King.
Okay, okay.
You know, that was real cool. She's a cool chick, too.
Okay.
She is. And then behind you, I have myself and Kendra C. Johnson. She's an actress with Tyler Perry.
Okay.
She's also Single Moms Club, and also she's been on Love Thy Neighbor and all that. And then next to that, of course, is Tiny.
Yeah.
Myself and Tiny. But I have a whole onslaught of pictures that I elected not to put them up right now since I'm going to be moving. It didn't even make sense. I would have been putting them up and then taking them right back down. So the next place is going to be covered with pictures.
And I'm looking forward to come back for that one too.
Yeah, that'll be great. It's interesting though, Rodney, how some people, they'll come in, right, and it'll seem like to them, or they take for granted, like, you don't know nobody. You know how many times I've heard that?
Oh, yeah.
And I'll just look like.
Like, do you know how close-knit this industry is?
You don't know nobody. I was like, okay, whatever you say.
Believe what you want to believe.
We got some more folks from the Philippines tuning in. What's going on, y'all? Do you know how to say hello in Filipino?
Do I know how to say hello?
In Filipino?
I know how to say a few things.
A few. I just thought I'd ask. Hey, shout out over there to Two Rivers. Two Rivers is listening, my husband, Bobby. And all of the crew who didn't ask to listen to the show today, but you're listening anyway. Hey, and I was able to meet the front office.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, yeah. The other day I went by. Tamara, thank you so much. She helped us so much and was instrumental in getting us the documentation to move into our new home.
Mm-hmm.
You know, okay. I'd never met her, but I was able to meet her the other day. She made me get some pound cake.
She made you get some pound cake.
Yeah.
Big. Come on now.
Yeah,
She made you get some pound cake. Like, she forced it.
I wrapped it up, put it in the hand. I didn't even want it.
And
but I had to be nice and take it and say thank you.
Take one for the team. Go ahead.
Yeah, you know, I figured that's what I'm supposed to do.
Go ahead. Go home. Eat it. Because I know you didn't throw it away.
No, I did not throw it away, but I had to eat it because it was put in my hand.
Mm, okay.
But great crew over there. Appreciate you guys for being so nice and wonderful to my husband. I saw a different side of him. He was like, hey, how's everyone doing? But when he's dealing with some other folks, he'd be like, man, did I tell you to clock in on time?
Well, when and when, why is that?
I guess some folks ain't clocking in on time.
I don't even understand how people do that. I mean, the one thing that you have to do is get to work on time, clock in. If you can't do that,
but I don't know.
Anyway,
I guess some people take stuff for granted. I also heard recently from an employee that works for Coca-Cola, and also I heard it on the radio news talk that Coca-Cola is going through yet again their refining period. But for some of y'all that don't know, but you may or may not know, you know, Atlanta's a Coca-Cola town.
Oh yeah,
it's a Coca-Cola town. And what happens every 15 to 20 years? They go through this purging. They go through this refining period.
Mm-hmm.
And they let a lot of people go. And when I first started working with Georgia Magazine, they had gone through that period. And with my son being 14, that makes it about 15 years at that time, 14, 15.
Okay.
And a young lady there, Ms. Cutler, she was with Coca-Cola for 20 years.
Oh.
20 years she was with them. And they let her go.
Yes, it was.
Yeah.
They let her go
after 20 years. You know, she had a wonderful severance package and all kinds of stuff. They do really good, but they go through this every 15 to 20 years. And I told my buddy, I said, you sure you want to work for Coke? Because I know for sure you won't be, you know.
Yeah, you're not going to be a lifer.
You know, that's just not happening. But what I was told today is that the company's been around for 120 years. Mm-hmm. And they feel like they have to do that for, you know, the company. And making sure that everything
to keep that new blood in there.
Yeah.
Keep pushing forward.
Yeah, they do.
Any company that does not change will not succeed.
And I'm glad you said that, because we're changing here at the Beach Drop Radio. We're We're looking for new blood too. Yes, we are. It's going to be a whole new phase. I've already begun working on the new website.
Oh, really?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
I'm serious. The reset button is already being pressed, you know, and you guys will be seeing a new, you know, Beat Drops Radio.
A whole new image.
The home of the Bianca Belair Show. Yes. Yes, you will. And I'm looking forward to it because, like I said, things have to change. They have to, you know, in order for it to succeed.
And I agree.
And also, I'm going to say this. I was looking on Instagram this morning. And when I was looking on Instagram, I do that, see what people have going on, and people, you know, click like on my stuff or repost. That's pretty cool. Thank you. I appreciate you guys. But when I was looking, I saw that Oprah and Tyler Perry have gotten together, and they are giving away $1,000 to the first 50,000 followers to the Oprah Tyler Christmas handle.
Really?
Yeah, they just posted it up. Oprah put it on her page. Tyler put it on his page. And then I went to the Oprah Tyler, and it is legitimate. That was cool. So, you know, you have to follow them, of course.
See, you got more stroke than I do. I don't follow people like that. I'm not on your level.
Oh, whatever, man. But you got to follow them. Of course, you must have an Instagram account. But you follow them, shout them out. And what I did was I did a screenshot, followed them, and then I reposted and just, you know, basically said, you know what, I appreciate people like you. It's not like you've got to do things for recognition. They already have that.
Right.
But, you know, just to help folks. And at that time, they only had a little over 3,000 followers to that handle. So y'all might want to get on it.
So I guess you already got your name in there.
Yes, I do.
Yes.
Yes, I do.
I'll be on the streets of Instagram in next commercial break.
Speaking of Instagram, I don't know if any of you all have seen that Instagram went through an entire cleanup. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw part of that.
They got rid of all the fake accounts.
A lot of fake accounts.
And who took the hardest hit was Justin Bieber. He lost over 3 million fake followers. Now, there are some, and they had this whole list. There are some that once they purged, now I didn't lose any because I don't have any fake followers. And I don't pay. I've always said that. All of my followers and quote fans, but all of those people who I network with, that's genuine. I don't pay any money for that because if I have, I'd be embarrassed right now.
Oh yeah. Besides, I mean, it doesn't matter how many followers you have. If you're not interacting with them, it's meaningless.
Yes, a good point. Hey, Mr. McKenzie. Mr. McKenzie just sent me a message. How you doing, sir? He is the owner. He is the creator of Provache, which you hear advertised here on the Beat Drops Radio. He also is the creator of Afro Sheen back in the day. Remember Afro Sheen?
I remember that.
Yeah.
Talking about how he got out there.
Yep.
Yeah, I remember that.
Phenomenal.
That was deep.
Yeah, Afro Sheen, Bump Patrol. He's the creator of Bump Patrol as well. It's a lot of products that he has created. He's hundreds of them. And he sold a lot of that, but his current right now is Provache, P-R-I-V-A-S-H-A-V-E, Provache.com. He's a really, really cool guy, and he has a lot of experience, and he shared a whole lot with me that he didn't have to, and I appreciate that. So, hey, what's going on, Mr. McKenzie? So I had to do that because he let me know before that. Now I'm laughing. He let me know. I'm sorry, man. I get messages. Okay, he let me know.
Oh, yeah. I've gotten one where I got yelled at, too, for not saying hello.
Who did you not say hello to?
When you asked me if I knew how to say hello. And it just kind of, like, skipped my mind. I couldn't think of it. I got yelled at.
You get to see. Yeah. Just saying. You know, you got to be on top of it. When we come back, because we're going to take a brief break. When we come back, we're going to talk about this situation that happened in Berkeley, Missouri. I have the sound bites of the mayor. From the press conference that took place earlier this morning. And I also have the Q&A. The Q&A is pretty interesting. It's pretty long. So okay. We'll just kind of gauge it as to which one. It's in two parts. So okay. Keep it locked right here on the Bianca Burwell Show. Jagged Edge off of their new one, Hope. Keep it locked.
Aaron has muscular dystrophy and cerebral palsy.
I'm Rita Gray from Betty White's Out There Rockers, but unfortunately, he's no longer with us now. Each year, thousands of cases go unreported where children with disabilities and special needs get abused in their schools. Our mission is to protect the child, as well as the teachers who educate them. Please, help us in our effort to stop the abuse and promote safety by donating to positive initiatives in care of Aaron Hatcher's They Can't Talk, But We Can, Inc. P.O. Box 2392, Roswell, Georgia, 30077. Or visit our website at theycanttalkbutwecaninc.org. Let's not have another loving, innocent child like Aaron die. Remember, they can't talk, but we can.
You are tuned in to the Bianca Burwell Show on the BJoss Radio, your top 40 private army station. New baby little! And I have a special in-studio guest with me, my brother.
Hey.
Rodney Evans Sr.
Senior, yes.
I guess I do have to say senior. Because
yeah, I don't go by, yeah. But yeah.
You do have a son.
Yes, I do.
Little Rod, but he ain't
no
more.
Not a little more. So 23. He's getting up there.
Man, when does it happen? It just seems like, man, St. Petersburg, what's going on? Tomorrow, the folks. How you doing? Appreciate it. All right, so we've all, if you haven't had the opportunity to see the news, there's a situation that has taken place in Berkeley, Missouri. Berkeley, Missouri apparently is only about a couple miles away from Ferguson,
yes.
And we've heard about Ferguson quite a bit. There's been a lot of marches, things of that nature. People have said some interesting things in regards to Michael Brown. And recently, I can't wait. I was listening to the Rush Limbaugh show on the way in, but he's on vacation right now. So otherwise, I'd have some colorful things to say about him right now.
I'm actually kind of glad he wasn't there because Rush, I'm sorry. I know you listen to him.
Yeah.
But besides being colorful, I can't take him for more than 2 minutes at a time.
Really?
Yeah, he's a complete idiot.
Well, you know, people listen to him.
Unfortunately,
yes. It's a lot of people that listen to Rush Limbaugh, and they kind of take what he says as
gospel.
Yeah, they do. So, being in media, I need to hear what it is that he's saying. Him and Sean Hannity. Sean Hannity had to do some real backpedaling recently when he was supporting this individual farmer.
Oh yeah, yeah. the sovereign.
Yeah.
The sovereign individual.
Yeah. They come to find out that this dude is saying he didn't know if black people were better off now or being slaves.
Slaves, yeah. What kind of foolishness.
So the network was like, good for ratings, but cut ties. So he had to back up.
Yeah.
But it's very interesting how people jump on things. And the reason why I'm saying that is because we talked about in previous shows how there was one testimony, so-called testimony in the grand jury, of this lady who's inserted herself into the investigation of what happened in Ferguson, and she was able to testify in front of the grand jury.
Right.
And she was the only one that corroborated Darren Wilson's, that's officer's, story about Michael Brown head down charging towards officer.
Right.
I don't know, the 20, 30, 40, 50 other people that were around.
They didn't matter.
Said his hands were up, but they hung everything on that. Then later on it comes out that she was nowhere near and she got her story from things that she read.
Wow.
I can't wait
to
see what Rush Limbaugh. I've been waiting. That's what I'm waiting for.
Well, maybe that's the reason why he's not on right now. just call it a vacation if you want to.
A little vacation. Sean Hannity, apparently he hasn't gotten the memo. So I was thinking about Instagramming him.
Oh.
Yeah, I was thinking about Instagramming him.
Wait, you follow him on Instagram too?
No. But I would just send him a direct message. Okay. You can do that. You can do like the handles or hashtags, and they'll get it.
Okay.
Yeah. And let him know and send him the story and see how well he backpedals.
How will he get out of that one? Yeah.
You know, because he was adamant the other day when I was listening to him. He was like, people just jump on. They feed this narrative about, you know, white cops and unarmed black teens, and they just stir up trouble. And never mind that, because what they were saying, just popped in my mind.
I could see what.
Yes. What they were saying was that President Barack Obama has been wrong on everything dealing with race.
Oh, really?
That is what Sean Hannity said his radio show. He's been wrong about everything regarding race. He was wrong about Ferguson. He was wrong about Eric Garner. He was wrong to send in Eric Holder to the situation. He's wrong about racial relations now.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, one thing that kills me, and I heard this interview, and I can't remember who it was, but it was a white person. And don't get me wrong, I look at people as people. I don't dislike any race. I dislike stupid people because I can't stand stupidity. That's just me.
I got a shirt like that. It says that.
Yeah.
Sorry.
But when it comes down to it, now I've only heard one white person ever say this, and this guy said, "We will never know what it is like to be black." Mm-hmm. To this day, how can a white person, a Caucasian person, tell a black person or an Asian person or a Hispanic person what kind of racism that they see?
Well, they try because they look at some of the things on the news, and they have black friends.
But that irritates me. I've got black friends.
I have black friends. So therefore, that's sufficient. I have black friends, and they have told me some of their struggles.
Some of their struggles.
Yes.
You have different types of black people. You have the boys in the hood.
Yes.
You have your college educated.
Yes.
Then you have your completely confused, don't even know what they are, trying to fit into every other race that there is. Okay. There's levels to this.
Yeah. And I think it's like that on every spectrum. You have.
Yes, I agree.
Every race. Well, I don't want to say it like that. And what made me rethink that is some people have the argument, you know, it's the human race, and it is.
It is, absolutely.
And we're divided up amongst colors, unfortunately. I can't stand the term. It's just me personally. I can't stand the term African American.
Me neither. When's the last
everybody
time? Look at me. Do I have an afro?
So
what am I now? Since I shaved my head, am I still an Afro American? I haven't had an afro since
I don't like Afro American. I don't like African American when they put people, because I've run across folks that are black, like you and I, but they're not from Africa.
And when you start traveling, because you know I travel quite a bit, and I've been a lot of places, and you can walk up to someone and start talking. When I was living in New York, perfect example, I walk up to somebody and I start asking directions, because you know that's what you do when you don't know where you're at.
Yeah.
Dude didn't understand a word I was saying. Not a word. He looked black.
See?
You have that everywhere.
Yeah, you do.
Costa Ricans, Puerto Ricans, and it's not just the Hispanic cultures either. You also have some of the Asian cultures where they're also dark skinned. You never know.
Panamanians. Those from Panama, I'm Mexico.
Middle Eastern.
You know, you just can't, that putting everybody under umbrella. But what I've noticed now is that when I look at things and you check off, it might be job application or whatever, it says non-Latino.
Yeah.
What is that? Have you seen that?
Yeah, I just kind of breeze over that. Like, that has nothing to do with me.
What is that? I'm sorry. I know I went off on a tangent, but I'm just saying.
I don't know.
Those types of things, just I can't stand that.
So other. What is other?
I don't know. Maybe it might be something else.
And I really don't understand why that's on there anyway, because it's illegal to hire or not hire based on color. So they shouldn't even know. It shouldn't even be on application.
They need to know.
Let me digress.
Demographics. They want to know exactly so that they feel like, I guess, it's a possibility that they can't be accused of not hiring quote-unquote minorities.
Right, right.
That might be the case.
But it's illegal to base your hiring practices and firing practices on race, age, sexual orientation. Hey, I ain't saying. I'm just saying.
Well, so Sean Hannity was saying that President Barack Obama not only has been wrong on all race relations, but he accused President Barack Obama and Al Sharpton to be anti-police.
Anti-police.
And it was he and former Mayor Rudy Giuliani that were having this conversation.
Wow.
Yeah.
I did not hear that.
Yeah. You know, I'm listening to the news all the time. I'm watching it. And I was like, what? I couldn't put it up fast enough. And I was driving down the street, and I was like, is this about a whoopity whoop?
Mm.
anti-police. How do you come up? And there are those people that only listen to one side of
yes.
I cannot stand that. And then they draw a conclusion
yep.
based upon that without even considering
yes.
or looking. Matter of fact, Gabrielle Union, you know who she is.
Yes, I know who she is.
She's now married to Dwayne Wade, right?
Yes.
And she was on an interview, and she was talking about where is people's compassion? You don't have to relate totally, but damn, that's what she was saying. She was like, you know, you got a man who was choked to death on the street in front of people.
Right.
You've got, you know, somebody who's gunned down, people losing their children. Damn, where's your general compassion for others and people, the comments that were rolling in.
I have lost a few Facebook friends based on some of the stuff that they were saying about, oh, look at them and how they're acting. And, you know, there's a difference. It's not just black people that riot. Look at some of the worst riots we've had in history. They had nothing to do with politics. Mm. Let a hockey team win.
Oh, man.
Let a basketball game. I mean, there have been more
fires, turning over stuff.
Turning over cars.
Yeah.
And I hate to say this. Yeah, that was over a sporting event. And I hate to say this. Wasn't a lot of black people out there.
No.
But that wasn't the media.
No, that was a celebration riot.
Oh, yeah.
That was a celebration.
There's a difference.
Setting things
because
on fire.
People got killed and there was looting, but it was because of a sporting event. It wasn't because of an unjust shooting. Oh, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah. It does. That's how that rolls. When people rationalize things, you know, and try to make it seem like it's okay. Not too long ago, we had attorney Musa Guyahim in here, and I appreciate him. He's a practicing attorney. He does have a practice here in the Atlanta metro area, and he also is a former prosecuting attorney, okay? So he expressed a whole lot. I had questions in regards to, you know, the grand jury, the process, you know, getting indictments. He said he's never had not one time where he's never gotten an indictment.
Really?
Nancy Grace has said the same thing. She practiced law here in the Atlanta metro area, and she said she's never seen you not get an indictment. They said, and he expressed, if you want to indict a ham sandwich, you can get it. For you to not get an indictment, you are trying very hard not to get an indictment. But I want to roll back from that for a minute because the situation has taken place.
Okay.
And
getting back to Berkeley.
Berkeley, Missouri. And I know some of you guys are waiting, Mike, really? Are you ever talking about it yet? And just to give you a brief before we play the clip, it's going to be a short clip about Mayor Theodore Hoskins. I had to do, you know, pull up his history a little bit here. And he has been a resident of Berkeley for 45 years. So he's not somebody that's a stranger to the community there, which is great. He's married, has two daughters. He served in the United States Air Force, same as our daddy. And he left with an honorable discharge. Honorable discharge. He received his education. Basically, he's got an associate's in business administration. He's got a degree, a bachelor's degree in business administration from the University of Missouri. So basically, he's a home guy. He's a homeboy.
Yeah.
You know, he's been there for quite some time.
In the community.
Yeah. Yeah. He was elected to Missouri House of Representatives November 2002, represented District 80, and has served in the 92nd, 93rd, and 94th General Assembly of the Missouri General Assembly. In 2005, he voiced his support for set-asides for minority and women-owned businesses to Governor of Missouri, Matt Blunt. So he's been pretty active in the community, and people appreciate that. You know, having somebody who knows exactly what is going on. So what I'm going to do, and we'll keep the sound up so those that are watching now and those that will watch later, because I know how to hashtag, you know, what it is that he said. And like I said, this is recently Mayor Theodore Hoskins and what he had to say in regards to this shooting. So listen up.
I received a call that a young man by the name, and we don't have to, until we find out that all the family members have been notified, we're going to hold his name. In addition to, we're going to also hold the police officer's name until the investigation is completed. And I can assure you it's going to be a thorough investigation. in reference to that. I had the opportunity last evening to review the video of the incident. And what I saw in this incident, it's not what people portray. This is not a policeman in the city of Berkeley, a half-cock going out, and as we say, you know, Black Lives Matter. This was not the case. This is, you could even compare this with Ferguson or the Gardner case in New York. The Gardner case in New York, they had the video. Ferguson, they did not. We have the video. And I can assure you that what's on the video is what we're going to use. See, I don't believe they used the video in New York for whatever reason. You know, maybe the elders of our community have better eyes than we do. But the city of Berkeley will be doing the investigation along with the St. Louis, in parallel with the St. Louis County. And our overall goal is to project the truth to the residents. Because the first thing occurred last night was, and when I got there, we were all saying the same thing. Here's a white policeman killing a black young man. So when does this stop? And I can assure you that did not happen last night. We had a policeman responding to a call, protecting the residents of the city of Berkeley. And the call came through the dispatch office in reference to this young man was shoplifting. When the officer came there, the video shows that the deceased pointed a gun that has been recovered at the officer. And I think that the officer, because he stumbled, might have saved his life. Because when he stumbled and had a chance to fire and take this young man's life, he was fortunate enough in his stumble that one shot was necessary to take his life. So, the St. Louis County now is doing their investigation. City of Berkeley is doing its independent investigation. And we don't want to jump ahead and provide you with some information that later, similar to the Ferguson, we have to retract. So what are we going to do now? City of Berkeley's police department will be doing this investigation independently from St. Louis County, okay? And let me first thank all of the cities that responded last night to protect the property, because if pulled 1,000 and they had not responded, Quick Trip probably would not be standing today. Mm-hmm. And because of the quick reaction of going over to protect that, the city of Berkeley is grateful for what those officers, you know, officers put their life on the line every day. And we are proud of that. So.
All right, so that's a brief synopsis, overview. And after that, the mayor opened it up for Q&A. So I'm going to ask you, I don't know if you had a chance to hear that press conference, did you?
No, I did not. This is the first I heard it. I saw the video that he refers to. I watched it during the break.
What's your thoughts about some of the things that he had said during the press conference?
I'm very happy that, number one, they are going to use video, because you cannot, well, in this case, it's not very easy to fake the video.
Right.
Second of all, I do like that they are doing independent investigations,
yes,
instead of doing a joint investigation.
Glad to hear that.
Because a joint investigation, a lot of times, waters things down. It is much better to get several perspectives on the same thing, because you always have three sides to a story: yours, mine, and the truth.
Yep.
So yeah, I'm happy to hear that.
I like how he handled the whole thing. You know, he wanted to make sure, but at this point, they have released the name, so. Since he said he was going to hold it until, and the young man's name is Antonio Martin, 18 years old. And, you know, he was armed. And he made it clear during it. And what I'll probably do is run the entire thing on the station a little bit later on, so people who haven't heard it mm-hmm. will have an opportunity to hear the entire thing plus the Q&A.
Okay.
Because there was a young man in there that was very animated, and he was like, he's gonna make the comparison between Ferguson and this situation, and you can't.
This is apples and oranges. This is completely different. Just looking at this video is completely different. Because even when I looked at it, I was like, is that fool pulling out a gun?
He pulled out a gun and he pointed it at the officer.
Yeah.
I guess he felt like, and there's also other videos, and I will post it to our Facebook fan page, that, you know, they showed the aftermath, and people converged upon that QT. It was just absolutely crazy. So many people.
Wow.
And, you know, officers were pulling up left and right, and they weren't trying to, you know, beat nobody down. They was really just trying to keep everybody calm. And then other people that were there were trying to keep people calm.
Which is good.
But somebody threw an explosive. I'm talking about feet within the freaking gas pump.
No, that's bad.
What are you thinking? You're at a gas station, idiot.
People are stupid. When you get that mob mentality,
yes,
all logical thought goes out the window.
Completely out the window. And apparently that is something that took place. But, you know, it's absolutely crazy. It was a lot of chaos. The video is about 2.5 minutes long, just showing the different things that took place and people's tempers flaring, you know. So now the armed teen Antonio Martin, he was shot and killed by a Berkeley police officer Tuesday night at the mobile gas station in the 6800 block of North Hanley Road. We have a lot of people that tune in and listen from St. Louis. I don't even know who all I know in St. Louis, but I appreciate y'all for tuning in. Jeez. Serious, I appreciate it. So what he wanted to do was let people know, and I appreciate Mayor Hoskins for it. He did not want the comparison to be made,
right?
And he does not believe this is a racially motivated shooting. He's saying we are different from the city of Ferguson. Now, the reason why he says that is, and we all know 80 to 95% of our policemen serve our community well. So jumping to the conclusion without investigating is unacceptable, and he has some fine officers. Now, some people were questioning in regards to the racial divides and things of that nature. He said the majority of officers in Berkeley are African-American, and so is the city staff. He says our police officers are more sensitive, and it's because of the black and white relationship and because they interact with a majority of black policemen. So you get a better understanding, which is why I think we're different from the city of Ferguson. We don't have major crime in the city. This is unique. Now, somebody was asking, and I heard it during the actual press conference,
okay,
you know, about, well, how many, because we talked about that in Ferguson,
right?
It was only like three.
The racially divided, yeah, you know, three black officers.
That's it?
Yeah.
Out of what, 53?
And the majority of the community is black.
Yeah. So, of course, there was tensions there. The mayor says that there are 31 officers in Berkeley. Of those officers, 18 of them are African American, all right? 18.
Okay.
And now, this individual that was very colorful that I'm mentioning, that, you know, kept trying to force it, and after a while, the mayor cut him off. Like, we gonna go to somebody.
Yeah. Should have shut him down, yeah.
You know, he was trying to give him that respect. He told him that it wasn't the same or whatever. And this young man was saying that all police officers have to do is say that. He said, because it's the same MO. It's the same, you know, a white police officer shooting a black man, a young black teenager, mm-hmm. and now we have another one that's dead.
Right.
All the officer has to do is say, I feel threatened, and they
right.
can be justified in shooting. And he said, this is not the same. And what he told him was, is everyone doesn't die the same. Right, that's
yeah,
what he said.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Everybody doesn't die the same. He said some people die because the police initiated, while some die because they initiated it.
Right.
And at this point, our review indicates that the police did not initiate, like in Ferguson.
That's right.
I like how
you put that on there. You see what you did there, right?
Yes, I did.
Yeah. I'm just making sure it wasn't just me.
No, it's not you. I saw exactly how you did that. Because he even, in the clip, he talks about how they have video in New York, but maybe they have different eyes than what we do.
Right. They see things a little bit differently than we do.
But we had the video.
And we will use the video.
We will use it. Now, there also was another question because they have issued, there. It's not that many body cameras for the police officers. We know about this.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
There aren't that many that, there's some issue, but not a lot. And there are dash cams.
Yes.
So one of somebody from the Associated Press asked, well, are you concerned that the dash cam wasn't turned on and that there was no body camera? He said, at this point, I'm not concerned about it because we do have a video. We can see what's happening mm-hmm. and what happened. He said, now, after a whole lot of training later on and something happens and the dash cam isn't on and the body camera isn't turned on, then I'll be concerned. Yeah. He said, but right now, I don't see any reason to be concerned. He seemed like a real cool dude.
That would be hinting towards that police officer in Cleveland. Just saying.
This dude, I like this man. He has a way with words.
Yes, he does. And if you're paying attention, you hear him throwing out a whole lot.
You might not even pay attention. Yeah. Mayor Theodore Hoskins. I appreciate you, guy. And all the things that he had to say about that. So,
good job.
Definitely. Keep it locked right here on the Bianca Burwell Show. We'll be back with more Black Sheep. The choice is yours. Keep it locked. You are tuned in to the Younger Boy World Show on the BJoss Radio with your top 40 pop and R&B station, New Beat of Atlanta. It is, do you see how dark
it
is?
It got dark fast.
It seemed like I just looked over there. And then I looked again and it got real dark.
Okay, I do not, and I want to stress, I do not miss the weather here in Atlanta. It's been raining since I've been here. Do you know what it's like in Houston? I got people sending me messages talking about, oh, it's 71 degrees, got the windows open. It's been raining since I've been here.
Yes, it has. It's been real nasty.
Flash flood warnings, man. Ooh.
I cannot believe that's a fast moving cloud. You know,
it's not even 4:30.
No, it's not.
Crazy.
It's not. And there were some. I think it was a bad storm that's been moving through.
Oh yeah, it has been.
I think some tornadic action took place somewhere else. I can't remember exactly where it was.
Up in Floyd County, Rome, where I used to live. Shout out Rome, Georgia.
Rome.
Yeah, they got hit pretty hard.
Yeah, so you guys be careful out there when you're driving.
Please, there's accidents all over the place.
Some folks are traveling for the holidays, you know, all that other kind of stuff. So just be careful out there and drive with caution. It's some folks that just, I don't know what it is, that when water hits the pavement, they have no idea how to react to it. It's just like they speed up and hit brakes hard and turn in front of you when they know they don't have space. I mean, it's just all kinds of craziness.
They drive like the road's completely dry, like they have full control of the vehicles.
Exactly. Look at that. That's crazy. All right. Well, I brought my umbrella in.
I'm rolling with you, so.
Definitely. It's something I just saw that just popped up on, and this is coming from New York or NYMag.com. FDA just likes pissing off gay people. They enjoy it. They can put mandates in. They can change guidelines. I think they enjoy.
What did they do now?
Pissing off. Okay, so the FDA, they recommended changes to, there was a 31-year-old ban on blood donations.
Okay.
You know, from men who have had sex with men.
Yes, okay.
So now they're instead suggesting that potential male donors should have abstained from same-sex sex for at least a year before giving the gift of life.
Oh, my goodness. Are you for real?
I am for real. Go to NYMag.com daily. The title of it is Gay Men React to the FDA's Proposed Blood Donation Guidelines. I kid you not. That is what is up right now.
Only in America. Only in America.
The new guidelines stem from the fact that gay and bisexual men are more likely to be HIV positive than the general population, and therefore have a higher probability of donating infected blood. Now, we know all blood is
screened, yes.
We know that it's screened, but it doesn't matter to the FDA, doggone it. And apparently, according to this article here, it leaves many gay men and advocates, thank you, confused about the new proposal. For many, what they're saying is that a 12-month abstinence period is like a life sentence. It's like, they're like, what are you saying?
Hey, trust me, 12 months can feel like a life sentence.
Yeah. That's what they're saying. The policy seems to target individuals based on their identities rather than the behaviors they engage in. So the gay men's health crisis, which doesn't only serve gay men, if you will, mm-hmm. But was founded first as a response to the AIDS epidemic.
Yeah.
They called the new guidelines, they just harmful. Harmful. By implementing this policy, the FDA will continue to fan flames of the outdated stereotype that HIV is only a gay disease.
So what's next? If your toenail's too long, you can't get blood?
No, they just like pissing off gay people. I'm just
saying. Oh my goodness.
Who can say anything?
Seriously.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
that really makes no sense, because how many people do you have that you don't know that they're gay? Now, we all know you have the ones that you be, hey, you know,
yeah.
But, you know, you got people on the DL. How do you know?
Yeah.
And is it gay men only? What about women?
Well, they said the same-sex men. I guess they're not too worried. I don't know. They should be concerned about lesbian women, too.
It's not like the disease isn't there.
Yeah, it is.
And it's not just in the gay community.
No, it's not. It definitely isn't. And there are so many men that have played that role.
Yeah.
And, you know, they bring it home.
Yeah.
They bring it home. They might have bent over.
Any circumstance, any kind of details.
They might have bent over. You never know. Yeah. And then they just decided, you know what?
I ain't bending over, so I don't be better.
Yeah, I don't think you will.
You know me.
That is not you in any form of fashion whatsoever. So
just clarifying that, everybody out there.
So the movie Selma.
Okay.
Have you seen the trailers for it?
No, I've not.
This is a movie. Oprah Winfrey is She's instrumental in it. I love Oprah. I think you know that. I've looked at Oprah and studied the things that she's done. And even my mentor, as far as entertainment is concerned, you know, he told me some things like what made the difference between Oprah and all the rest of Sally Jesse Raphael, mm-hmm. Donahue, and all the mm-hmm. rest of them.
Okay.
And she was just on, is that Fallon?
Oh, Jimmy Fallon?
Jimmy Fallon.
Okay.
She was on his show not long ago.
Oh, so Oprah's doing interviews now.
Yeah, it was okay. Pretty cool. They played her theme song when she came out. She had the little dance. Do, 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 do. Yeah, she worked it out. So he was like, I'm so excited to have you on the show. She was like, really? And she told him that, you know, Tyler Perry said hello. And he was like, oh my God, really? Jimmy Fallon is. He's an idiot. I like him.
He's great. Oh, and amazingly talented, too.
Yeah, I really, really like him. So at any rate, you know, they talked about the movie Selma.
Okay.
And apparently on Christmas Day, it opened in a couple of cities, New York and L.A., and then everywhere January the 9th.
Okay.
Yeah. And I think it's kind of critical right now at this point, because when they showed clips of it, he was saying it's just hard to believe that this was just 50 years ago. She was like, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was just 50 years ago. So I do plan to see the movie. I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah.
But I do plan to see it.
I will see it. It takes me a minute because, you know, I have to give those movies time to marinate. Like, I couldn't just run out and go see 12 Years a Slave. I had to give it a minute because I know I'm going to get a little bit of attitude.
Well, you know, 12 Years a Slave, I did watch that. And I watched it with my son and daughter
mm-hmm.
because I felt it necessary for them to see it. And, you know, they both had reactions. My son kind of held it in and was like, like, look at that movie. Like, and then my daughter, you know, she was That's what was happening.
Okay.
You know, with me, I was just like, wow, man, this did happen.
This
is not a part
of. It's not ancient history.
No, it's not. And it's not things that we can kind of turn a blind eye and say that it didn't happen. You know what I found so interesting when I was watching CNN and MSNBC the other day?
Mm-hmm. What's that?
There was a situation that had taken place. One of the commentators said, and it's interesting when they pick and choose to say this comment, because obviously they don't want it to apply to this one. But what they said is that in order for us to move forward, we have to really look and see the things that has happened as to why we got to this state and condition. I said, oh!
What?
But he wasn't talking about black-white relations. He was talking about a particular company. And I was like, that's relevant across the board.
I mean, it applies to everything.
Yeah, that's relevant across the board. And I was like, why? How could you possibly say that that only applies in certain areas?
So that's where, to tie it back in, so Jimmy Fallon said, it's hard to believe that that was only 50 years ago.
Good segue. Yes.
Appreciate
yes,
it.
Yes. Hard to believe that it was only 50 years ago. She was like, yeah. And, you know, she said the reason why she did the movie is she felt that it was really important, especially to focus on the role of the individual that she's playing. I'm trying to scan to see what the name is of the person that she's playing. Was a real character. She's not, like, playing somebody who's made
up. She's not a made-up character. Okay.
Yeah, she's not. But is this Jimmy Lee Jackson? Well, what it is in regards to this female that she's playing the role of,
mm-hmm.
she just got tired. She had been trying to go down there and register to vote. It was like her fifth time trying to register to vote.
Okay.
And in this clip that they show, the gentleman down there said, now what would they think if they knew you came down here causing the fuss? She said, I'm not causing no fuss. I'm just trying to register to vote. So he said, recite the preamble. And she did it. How many mayors in whatever area it was?
So he just said, start running down.
She said, 67. He said, name them.
Really?
And then took out the little stamp and marked rejected.
Really? Name them.
Name them. He wanted her to name all 67. He knew. Hell, he could have even named all 67. She could have just named off Ralph, Donald, Bill. You know? And he wouldn't have known, but he still would have rejected it. And not too long ago, not too long ago here, we talked about the Harvard students taking that test that was for, you know, those trying to, you know, just vote.
Just to register to vote, yes.
And they all failed it. They all failed the test because they had 10 minutes to answer 30 questions correctly. And they weren't like, you know, what's 1 + 1?
Right. And I'm pretty sure, and they weren't multiple choice.
No. They says, draw a straight circle around something. They said, how could you draw a straight circle? Because it will be under the guise of, okay, a literacy test to make sure that the person can read.
Right.
Yeah, that's how it was masked. But that wasn't the intent.
No, the intent was to make sure that they had no opportunity whatsoever and that they felt emasculated.
Yeah. And they can say, well, we gave you an opportunity.
Yes.
We gave you an opportunity. Yep. You didn't pass the test, so therefore you can't vote.
Yep.
You know, and these types of things, that bakes into, you know, a lot of how people feel, their reactions mm-hmm. to things, you know, all the different type of stuff that has taken place through history.
Right.
And, you know, when we say 50 years, our mother was in her 20s.
That is not a long time ago.
No. Our dad was in his 20s.
Our brother was just born.
Yeah. And they still were dealing with not being able to vote, not being able to do all kinds of stuff.
Yeah. And at that time, 50 years ago, they were in, because, you know, Bobby was born in Texas.
Yes.
And I don't know if you know much about Wichita Falls.
No, I don't, actually.
Yeah, it's a place there. And, I mean, recently, there was a sign. And I'm talking about after the year 2000, because I've been in Texas since 2001. And recently, there was still a sign spotted saying, don't let the darkness catch your black in town.
You know, it's almost better to be to deal with people that you know how they feel about you.
Yes.
Be straight.
Good, bad. You know, I can respect someone who lets me know they don't like me.
Yeah.
You know, because you know what? I don't have to like you either.
Nope.
But if we have to deal with each other, you know, be adults, deal with each other, and then when you walk away, it's a done deal.
It's a wrap.
It's a wrap.
It's crazy. You know, it's just crazy. And you know, I don't want to seem like I'm just trying to force a whole lot, but I just feel like that our younger children, that generation needs to know the types of things that have taken place in order for them to be able to sit on a school bus.
They have no clue, but feel that everything is owed to them. They don't know, even even with us, things that I know what I went through growing up.
Uh-huh.
I know that you've gone through some stuff growing up.
Yes, I have.
I mean,
yes, I have.
They have no idea. No. And then the way they portray themselves, walking around. I cannot stand to see you walking around with your pants sagging.
That aggravates.
Oh, my goodness.
You know,
I told my son, if I ever see your pants sagging, I will staple them in place. Damn the belt. I'm stapling them in place. Okay? We had to have that talk. Look, man, you have got to do certain things in order to be able to come home safely every day.
Yeah.
There's none of this keeping it real. Keeping it real what? Well, stupid?
Yeah.
Retarded?
Yeah.
Keeping what real? You don't know what was real and what was not real because you haven't experienced anything.
Nope. I don't know where that came from.
Yeah, I mean,
as far as them feeling that way. I mean, we know that where the sagging pants came from.
Yes, we do.
You know, and they just have absolutely no idea what it means, or they've been told and just don't care. You know, we have relatives who have felt that way. It don't apply to me. No, it does.
It does. It absolutely applies.
It does. You must carry yourself in a way that people are not ready to shoot you on sight.
Exactly.
You know, that's just a whole culture mentality. I mean, man, even back in the late 80s and early 90s, we went through a phase of big clothes.
Yeah.
Baggy pants and all
tall
that.
Tall tees.
Looked like I remember somebody talking about Tupac saying Tupac looked like he had on his older brother hand-me-downs. You know, the baggy phase or whatever.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it just seemed like the pants have gotten, not only have they gotten further down the butt, but then they become tighter around the legs. And a lot of these boys look like girls.
Girls, yes, absolutely.
It's like they're feminizing the male.
How do you sag skinny jeans? Really?
Sag them down and then they still don't go nowhere. It's real tight.
Maybe they got smart and figured out if they were tighter, they wouldn't have to walk around holding their belt buckle because the pants keep falling down.
Is that what it is?
I guess. I don't know.
I
wear my pants properly and I make sure that my son does. And I try to make sure that other kids around me know how they should carry themselves.
Yeah, they should carry themselves accordingly because it's serious. I saw a clip, you know, from a family. The gentleman, they had three sons.
Mm-hmm.
I saw it on Facebook, but I thought it was, I should have copied and pasted it online. But he says, in my house, and you could tell they're both very educated.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But he said, in my house, there are some sneakers and loafers. They wear the khaki pants,
uh-huh.
and they wear the argyle or the sweater,
the vest, yes,
or whatever. And he said, there are no hoodies. There are no saggy pants. There mm-hmm. are no, he said, because we want our sons to come home safely.
Right.
That's what we want. We want our sons to come home safely. And you don't have those types of conversations that take place in other households.
No, you don't.
And shout out to International Noble. I appreciate him. He's down here. He moved down here from New York. And he's mixed with Puerto Rican and Black.
Okay.
And he's an artist, producer. He is newly signed with Monarchy. So I had him on for New Music Monday. And also, you know, he comes on periodically. Cool dude.
Okay.
But he had to remind me of something too. He said Black and Puerto Rican.
Yes. Because
we deal with the same thing. He's coming from New York. And,
right.
And I'm sorry, I must say this, because we were talking about it privately, but I don't have a problem with saying it openly. Puerto Ricans and Black people in New York, it's like brothers and sisters.
They're exactly the same.
It's brothers and sisters, yes. Up there.
Well, you know, when you came and spent time with me when I was living in New York, right? Mm-hmm. You saw it too.
Yeah. And, you know, you don't see that down here in Atlanta.
No,
it's
no.
a whole different situation.
World.
I was like, how can we all be? And then I had to be reminded there is a difference.
Big time.
Huge difference.
Big time.
So when we come back, we're going to talk about Sony, the movie, the interview, and all that other kind of stuff. Keep it locked right here on the Bianca Burwell Show. King, Mr. Commitment.
My life is full of statistics. 8 years, I could have dropped out of school and become one myself. But I did, because I had people that believed in me. Here's another statistic.
Do you have a synopsis of it?
Drop out every school,
do you have a synopsis of it?
That's one of what every 26 seconds.
No.
It's time that students know.
Can you see if you can pull that up?
Believe in this.
What is about
inspiring students? Be sure your message is.
I failed to pull that up.
My song, "Make It Out This Town," is about beating the odds. So it's
about
many littles live in single parent, low income, or military families. Too many kids, especially boys, are still waiting for a bill. Volunteer or don't. Start something. Big Brothers Big Sisters alumni, please start something again. Learn more at Big Brothers Big Sisters.
What's that I hear playing on your tablet?
Have you all heard?
Nope.
You are listening to the Bianca Werewolf Show, and I got in studio guest will be my brother, Rodney in the building.
Hey.
Luda. Boom. All right. So, Sony Pictures has definitely been in the news.
Oh, yeah.
With the whole entire situation with this movie called The Interview. Now, we know The Interview is a comedy. It is a comedy, and apparently, Kim Jong-un, did I say it right?
Yes, you
Kim
did.
Jong-un.
If you didn't, we gonna roll it anyway.
Apparently, he and his country do not look upon comedy very, as entertainment.
Oh, really?
If you do not, when it comes to the dictator and all that,
mm-hmm. Yes.
That's where the comedy stops.
Well, he killed his own cousin, so.
And his uncle, you know, that they just, he was like, ha, ha, hell. And.
So no sense of humor in office.
No sense of humor. As far as that's concerned, I believe they have one television station that basically is about the allegiance to the ruler.
Wow.
And, you know, and there have been many that have come forward
mm-hmm.
that have talked about from that country.
Yes.
They have talked about. You know, if you talk about, you know, the leader, the dictator, or whatever.
You are killed.
Yeah. That or jail time for, like, ever. You're not getting out.
It's crazy.
So, and they also have talked about, I think it's called the Bureau 121 or something like that. You know, that they have in regards to a whole bunch of hackers. A whole bunch of hackers that have gotten together. I mean, what they put together
right.
to hack into, you know, various countries and communities.
Mm-hmm, yes.
All right, the king. All, you know, countries and communities and whatnot.
Okay.
And they've done it in this situation. Sony,
yes.
All kinds of stuff that's been very embarrassing has come out.
Yeah, they released a whole lot of things, yeah.
You know, Kevin Hart. They called him a whore.
Ooh.
Yeah, they did.
Ooh.
Because he was saying that he wanted more money for the movie that was coming out and all the production and things that had to be done. He wanted more money.
Well, there's nothing wrong with asking for more.
Because if they wanted him to use his social media status, which he has a whole lot of followers that aren't fake.
Oh, he is killing it.
If you were going to use that, then you're going to pay me for it.
Exactly.
And I can see him saying that. Just like that.
Because it's a lucrative option for both.
Yes, it is. And he wanted more money, and they were like, they called him a whore. And he said, whatever, I don't have time to deal with that. I'm going to continue to focus on this empire that I am building.
That's right.
And that's what he did.
That's exactly what he should.
And you also have, what's her name? This married to Brad Pitt.
Angelina Jolie,
I mean, good gracious. She came down with the chicken pox right at the right time, didn't she? I can't. And she didn't look like she was upset to say that she can't make it to the event. I have the chicken pox. I'll be itching and at home. That's what she said. Y'all should look it up. She was like,
no,
peace
no.
out. I'm not coming. Bump all y'all anyway.
No calamine lotion for her.
Not at all. All right, so a day after Sony scrutinized screenings of the interview in a limited number of theaters, the studio announced that the film will also be available via on demand, y'all. So as first reported by CNN's Brian Stelter, we love giving credit, and later confirmed by Sony, viewers are able to rent or buy the film from YouTube Movies, Google Play, Microsoft's Xbox Video, and via CTheInterview.com. The cost is $5.99 to rent and $14.99 to purchase.
Oh, they even lowered it to purchase. It's usually $20.
Is it really?
Yeah, $19.99 a lot of times for new movies.
I didn't know. That's how much I don't, I guess we can tell that, huh? I just don't. But at any rate, you know, there are select indie theaters that will show the movie.
Yes, absolutely.
They will show the movie. Now, how do you feel about that? Are you cool with it?
Oh, I'm very cool with it. I'm happy because, number one, you know, the United States has always had a stance that we do not negotiate with terrorists.
Right.
And this was nothing but a form of cyber terrorism.
Yeah, it was, actually.
And there was promise that there was going to be a response.
Yeah, it was. I saw the president when he said that, you know, he's not going to say when, but it's going to be handled.
But do you know what happened?
What?
I have to throw this in there.
What happened? What?
Did you know, as of yesterday, and it was on the news, the entire internet for North Korea has been shut down.
Has it?
Yes.
They shut the whole...
the whole internet in the whole country.
It was
on the news last night. I was like, go ahead, President.
I missed that. I'm going to have to look at that.
Oh, the entire... it was on the news last night. Shut it down.
They said, boo.
Get out the way. Get out the way. Hey, get out the way.
Yeah, I like that. See, that's something about, you know, you can't... you might have hackers. I guess they didn't get that part of the intel. It will be shut down.
We hack too.
Yes. Yes, we do. So, you know, the president welcomes the news that people will be able to decide for themselves. I know that this is like real jacked up that this happened, but this has got to be the best PR that I've ever seen in my life.
It is. Because everybody's going to watch it.
This movie better be doggone good.
Yeah, for real.
It better be.
Hey, Seth, come on.
Yeah, right. Right. I like the those that are in the movie, you know, they say, now this is co-directed by Seth Rogen, did I say his name right?
Yes.
And
yes,
Evan Goldberg, the interview, focus on what happens when the CIA enlists an entertainment journalist, James Franco, and his producer, Rogen, to assassinate Kim Jong-un. You will now be able to watch the comedy as Rogen and Franco, probably always intended. And that is at home with a joint. Just don't do it alone. That was cool.
That's hot.
I can see them pretty much saying that. And in a lot of these states, you can blaze in your house. And if not, just get you one of them medical.
No, don't do that. Just go get you a hookah.
A hookah?
Go get you a hookah with some shisha, same effect.
Shisha?
Shisha, yes.
What the heck is it?
It is a virgin tobacco soaked in molasses. It's like smoking flavored air.
Our intern is like,
hey, I got two of them, I should know. I don't smoke anything illegal, but I love my hookah.
Well, you know, it's not illegal in some spots. I think here in Georgia, you can smoke it. Yeah. However, don't get caught across state lines because you're on your own.
I hear you.
That's just how that rolls. So you guys make sure you check out the interview.
Absolutely.
So apparently, check it out tomorrow and the day after and the next week. You know, rent it, all that stuff. We appreciate everybody for tuning in as I had my brother over here. I think he did a good job today, man.
Well, thank you for having me. I am used to talking to people.
Yeah.
But thank you for having me. I had a lot of fun. I can't wait to come back.
Definitely. If you haven't done it already, make sure you like us on Facebook by going to thebjossradio.com. Click on the F. And let me say this too. Rodney, you have a company called what?
I actually have two companies. Sensanity.
Sensanity?
Yes. It's a warming oil that you can also spray as an air freshener. Tearing it up. Hit me up on my website, sense-sanity.com. And you can also send me an email at rodney@sense-sanity.com. And now I also have a real estate investment company.
Ah.
We are flipping houses and we are wholesaling and doing quite a good job at it. And you can hit me up there at Rodney@EvansHomeSolutions.com.
Cool.
And like my Facebook page.
Yeah, my Enzo, but I can't, I'm sorry, I can't say your last name. I don't really have a, I'm sorry, let me say this real quick because I got a minute. I don't really have a reaction to people in Sweden celebrating Christmas on whatever day. And I'm going to tell you, in all actuality, Christmas has been, that date has been switched up all over the place anyway. So it really doesn't matter. They can pretty much do whatever they want to do. It's their prerogative. That country, Sweden, do your thing. I really don't care, honestly. All right. So, again, like us on our Facebook page. If you haven't done it already, go to thebeatjohnsradio.com. Click on the F. Once you click like, suggest us to all your people. And follow us on Twitter at @BeatDropsRadio. And like us on... Well, not us, but like me, or follow me on Instagram, Bianca_Burwell. And you can see everything that's going on as we hit the refresh button. I am looking for new blood, new shows, whole different website is coming soon. So make sure you stay tuned in.
Can't wait to see it.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
All right.
All right. We appreciate you. Later on, tune in for some more scheduled program content. Like how I said that?
Yeah.
Keep it alive.
What you did there.
Stay safe, you guys. Stay safe.
Peace.